Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today, I'm gonna be walking you through four mistakes you absolutely do not want to make when cold starting your engine. These four mistakes can lead to catastrophic engine failure, or at the least, they can significantly deteriorate the amount of life that your engine has left in it. When we talk about cold starts, I'm not specifically referring to when you turn your engine on in cold weather. A cold start is what we refer to when you turn your vehicle on for the first time in a number of hours to where your engine is completely cold and hasn't been running. So when you jump in your car in the morning and you haven't driven your car throughout the middle of the night, that is considered a cold start because your engine is completely cold and has to warm up from whatever temperature it's been sitting there at. While all of these tips are even more important in cold weather, I just wanted to point out that a cold start takes place anytime you turn your engine on, regardless of what the temperature is outside. Of course, in colder weather, your engine is gonna be colder when you initially start it. And so these are important tips to take into consideration in the winter months. But even if you live in Texas and it's 100 degrees, there are still things that you can do and mistakes that you can make when cold starting your engine that can lead to deteriorating the lifespan or causing serious internal engine damage. The first thing on the list is revving your engine or driving aggressively right after you start it. Metal components such as the internal pistons inside of an engine expand and contract when they get hot and cold. Engines are made to operate at their normal standard operating temperature. So before an engine gets up to its operating temperature, all of the components inside the engine are colder and more contracted than they should be, which gives them a lot smaller tolerances against the piston walls and all of the other internal metal components that they touch. Revving or driving your car aggressively before your engine has fully warmed up can cause excessive piston or cylinder wall wear, which can lead to premature engine failure if you do this time and time again. So number one mistake not to make is do not drive aggressively. Do not use too much gas until your car and your engine are fully warmed up. To do this, you'll want to go ahead and keep an eye on your temperature gauge and make sure the temperature gauge gets to the point that it's usually at after you've been driving for a while. The second mistake is letting your engine idle for too long. This is a very easy mistake to make, especially in the cold winter months when your car has auto start on it and you can turn it on and let it sit there to warm up the air while you're inside getting your coffee ready before you head out the door. But letting your engine idle for too long is bad because it can lead to fuel dilution, which is what happens when fuel ends up contaminating your engine oil. And what that does is decrease the viscosity and the lubricity of your oil, which therefore leads to excessive wear on your internal engine components. So number two, don't let your engine idle for too long, which brings us to point three, is also not letting your engine idle enough. Ideally, you wanna let your engine idle for approximately 30 to 60 seconds before you start driving it. You don't wanna get in your car, turn it on, and then start taking off and driving right away. And that's because we want to let the oil fully circulate throughout the engine before we actually start driving it. To get full oil circulation, it takes a little bit of time. And so we'll wanna let our engine idle for 30 to 60 seconds and then start driving. So points two and three go hand in hand together. You don't wanna let your car idle for too long, but you also wanna let it idle for 30 to 60 seconds before going ahead and driving. And in those first few miles of driving, you wanna take it easy on the gas pedal until your engine has time to fully warm up to operating temperatures. Because if you fail to do any of these, you could be causing excessive wear on all of your internal engine components. And wear on internal components is one of the leading causes of premature engine failure. And then a fourth thing on the list here that you do not want to do is drive your car a very short distance and then turn it off without letting the engine fully warm up. If you just get in your car, turn it on, drive it down the street and turn it off, that is bad for your engine. A good practice is to let your engine always fully warm up before you shut it off and get out of your vehicle. This can cause something similar to letting letting your engine idle too long. What ultimately happens is moisture and fuel vapors seep into your oil and decrease the lubricity of the oil, which again leads to increased internal engine wear. Additionally, it can also lead to excessive carbon buildup, which isn't good for your engine's performance either. So guys, that's our list of four things right there. We have revving the engine or driving aggressively before the engine's warmed up, letting your car idle for too long, not letting it idle for long enough, and taking short drives and turning your engine off before you allow the engine to fully warm up. Everything here has one similar theme, and that is letting the engine get up to proper operating temperature before we start abusing it, and not letting it sit around and idle for too long before we get all of the oil circulating properly within the engine. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our four mistakes you do not want to make when you start your car and the engine's cold. Hopefully these tips and tricks can help you extend the life of your engine, improve reliability, and increase the longevity that your vehicle has. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future videos.